If you came from my last video, welcome back. If not, it was just a very brief, simple, and fun 2 to 3 minute video on what a synthesizer actually is, tailored towards people who are new to them. In this second episode of my beginner synthesizer educational miniseries, we're going to figure out what synthesizers actually do by breaking them down into basic features and components, and explain the ones that are most common for almost every synthesizer. Before we jump into the features, let's settle a fairly important topic in the world of synths. Analog versus digital. Analog synthesizers were the first type of synthesizers to exist. They are called analog because they utilize basic electrical components to transform pure electricity into sound. One of the first commercially available analog synthesizers was created in the 60s by the legendary Bob Moog, an engineer and creator of the iconic Moog brand. Since then, many manufacturers would design their take on synthesis and present users with different options. Eventually, digital synthesizers utilizing digital computing would arise in the 70s and 80s with the legendary Yamaha DX7, popularizing digital synths as it was used in many hit songs of that era. The sound difference between analog and digital synths has been a matter of debate since the two existed side by side over the last several decades. Some may prefer the warmth and aliveness of analog, as there might be slight variations in sound over time in terms of pitch, timbre, and dynamics, while others may prefer the precision of digital and its ability to create unique sounds that would be quite a challenge to obtain with analog technology alone. Ultimately, everyone may individually hear and feel sounds differently, so it's up to the user and listener to decide what their preference is. Now let's dive into our first basic feature. Oscillators. Oscillators are just as they sound. They're the components within a synth that output basic waveforms. Some typical waveforms you may find are square, triangle, sawtooth, and sine. Oscillators inside an analog synth will be handled by actual discrete circuitry, while oscillators in a digital synth are handled by algorithms, and would usually only be limited by the computing power on board the unit. The more oscillators a synthesizer has, the more it can potentially make sounds which people often describe as being gritty, or fat, or thick, when the oscillators are stacked together to play a single note. Furthermore, multi-oscillator synths can have the option to blend multiple waveforms in order to create unique sounds. Voices. The number of voices determines how many musical notes can be heard simultaneously. A monophonic synth can only play one note at a time, while a polyphonic synth can play more than one. The usage of the word voices was likely derived from its usage in Old World music, when musical pieces were mostly sung in choirs. A Baroque-era composer like Johann Sebastian Bach would sometimes note on his score how many voices a piece of music would use. For example, this fugue played on the keyboard that follows his famous Prelude in C major indicates that it's in 4 voices, meaning that at any given time in this piece, only up to 4 musical notes will ever be heard at once. So similarly, a synthesizer description, which states that it has 4 voices of polyphony, like on the Korg Minilog XT, means that the synth can play up to 4 notes at the same time. Exclusive to synthesizers, however, is the concept of paraphony, where certain components or processes on the signal path are shared within the synth so that it has the flexibility of playing more notes. The digital Arturia Microfreak and the analog Uno Synth Pro, for example, both technically function as monophonic synths, capable of playing only 1 note at a time. But in their paraphonic modes, they can technically play more notes, just at the expense of outputting thinner sounds, since the oscillators are now tasked with playing more pitches. Altogether, the number of voices and oscillators combine to give us the total number of oscillators on board a synth. So it's important to note here that if a synth, like the four-voice mini-log, is described as having two oscillators, it is actually two oscillators per voice, meaning it will have eight effective main oscillators total. Envelope. An amplitude envelope, by default, shapes the volume, or amplitude as mentioned, of a sound over time, usually depending on four parameters: attack, decay, sustain, and release. The attack controls how immediate or gradual a sound reaches a peak, the decay controls how immediate or gradual a sound descends from that peak, the sustain controls the level at which the sound settles after the decay, or after the descent from this peak, and finally, the release controls how long a sound is still played after the sustain. This pretty much sums up part one of this episode. Be sure to like and subscribe in order to be notified when part two will be available. Thanks for watching.